हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू ऑल इन थर्ड ईयर इंजीनियरिंग। दिस इज माय फर्स्ट ऑनलाइन लेक्चर ऑन यूट्यूब इन योर क्लास। ड्यू टू कोविड 19 पेंडेमिक प्रेजेंटली द सिचुएशन इज नॉट नॉर्मल। देयरफॉर आई हैव डिसाइडेड टू क्रिएट यूट्यूब वीडियोस फॉर इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक सब्जेक्ट। सो माय हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू दैट यू ऑल have to listen all these YouTube videos and study this subject at home till the situation becomes normal. Similarly, I am also going to conduct live online session on Google Meet app for one-to-one discussion or any queries related to this subject. So, you must check the messages daily on your WhatsApp group. Similarly, your class coordinator also send you the weekly timetable for online live session for Google Meet or either Zoom app. Okay, so don't waste your valuable time now. Invest your time in study. Okay, so first of all, I would like to give you my introduction first. Myself, D.B. Ahire, pursuing PhD in wireless power transfer system for biomedical implant, and the principle of this system is also based on electromagnetics. Now, in this academic year, I am going to teach you electromagnetic subject in your class. Today, I am going to discuss the first topic, that is prerequisite for electromagnetic subject. Then we discuss the introduction to electromagnetics. Then we see the sources of electromagnetic fields, and then we discuss the effect of electromagnetic fields. But before that, let us see the syllabus, course structure, examination scheme, and similarly we discuss the course objective and outcome. Then we start the lectures. Okay, let's start now.
Okay, let us start with syllabus and course structure. This subject in teaching scheme has one tutorial, and in examination scheme this subject has 30 marks for in-sem exam and 70 marks for end-sem exam, and this subject has 4 credit. Now we discuss the course objective of this subject. The first course objective of this subject is to introduce the basic mathematical concept related to electromagnetic vector field. And this mathematical concept is very important for electromagnetic subject, because as you know, all these mathematical tools required for solving the problems of electromagnetic field, then it is very easy to understand this subject. And that mathematical concept are like vector algebra, vector calculus, then coordinate systems and their transformation, similarly some operators like gradient, divergent, curl, Laplacians. These are the some mathematical tools and concept for this subject, and this first objective we focus to discuss all these concepts first. We require at least 4 to 5 lectures to complete this concept, and then we start actual syllabus. Then in unit number 1st and 2nd, we cover the objective 2nd, and that is to impart knowledge on the concept of electrostatics, electric potential, energy density and their application. And then in unit number 3, we focus the third objective, that is to impart knowledge on the concept of magnetostatics, magnetic flux density, scalar and vector potential and its application. Then in unit number 4th, we discuss the 4th objective, that is to impart the knowledge on the concept of Faraday's law, induced EMF and Maxwell equation. And last two units, that is unit number 5th and 6th, we we focus the last objective, that is to impart knowledge on the concept of electromagnetic waves and transmission line. Okay, after completing this course, you must be able to know to understand the basic mathematical concept related to this electromagnetic fields. Then again, second outcome is to apply the principle of electrostatics to the solution of problem relating to electric field and electric potential, boundary conditions and electric energy density. And third outcome is to apply the principle of magnetostatics to the solution of problem relating to magnetic field and magnetic potential, boundary conditions and magnetic energy density. Then fourth outcome is from fourth unit, that is to understand the concept related to Faraday's law, induced EMF and Maxwell equation. And last outcome we satisfy, that is to apply this Maxwell equation to solution of problem relating to transmission line and uniform plane wave propagation. These are the outcomes. Okay, today we are focused first unit number first unit, and in unit number first we just discuss the first topic of unit number one, that is the sources and effects of electromagnetic field, and remaining topic of unit number one we discuss in next few units. So today we are going to start first topic, that is prerequisites for electromagnetic subject, and this prerequisite is nothing but the mathematical concept required for this subject, that is the first objective actually. And then we start the introduction, then application, and then devices, those are operated on this electromagnetic fields, then sources of electromagnetic field and effect of electromagnetic fields. Now prerequisites, we will focus this in detail in next unit, but we just see which topics we covered in next unit, that is first is the vector algebra, then we discuss the coordinate systems and their transformation, then we discuss the vector calculus. In vector algebra, we discuss the scalar and vector, then we discuss the unit vector, then how to perform the addition and subtraction of vector, then what is position and distance vector, how to perform the multiplication of vectors, and what is the component of vectors. That topics we discuss in vector algebra. We discuss the coordinate system and their transformation. That is Cartesian coordinate systems, then circular cylindrical coordinate systems, then spherical coordinate system and their transformation. Actually, these topics already you know, because in 11 to 12 standard, as well as in mathematics M1, M2, M3, these topics already you know. But we again just revise these topics because this topic is required for this subject. Again, in vector calculus, that is also in M3, this topic is also already covered, but we again focus these topics, that is the line and surface involvement integral. Then del operator and their properties. Then again we see the gradient of a scalar field and their properties. Then divergence of vector, then divergence theorem, curl of vector, again Stokes theorem, Laplacians of scalar, classification of vector fields, and examples of vector calculus. Now these topics we will discuss in 4 to 5 lectures after completing this lecture. Okay. So today we are going to discuss the first topic, this is theoretical actually, and then the subject is basically most mathematical. So we focus first the theoretical part and then we start the mathematical part also. So we first discuss the introduction of electromagnetic subject, then we see the applications in various disciplines, then EM devices, sources and effects of electromagnetic fields. Now first see the introduction. As you know, electromagnetics is a branch of physics or electrical engineering in which electrical and magnetic phenomena are studied. Therefore, it is a study of interaction between electric charges at rest and in motion. As if the electric charge is at rest, then that type of field is called as a static field. And if the charge is in motion, then that type of fields is called as a dynamic field, or sometimes also called as a time-varying field. So we discuss this both the statics and dynamic fields in this subject. Therefore, electromagnetic fields are the combination of invisible electric and magnetic fields of force. They are generated by natural phenomena, but also by some human activities, such as due to our use of electricity, that fields are produced. Because suppose as this is a conductor and suppose current is flowing through this conductor, then around this conductor that kind of fields are produced. That is the man-made electromagnetic fields. These man-made electromagnetic fields reverse their direction with time at a specific frequency, ranging from high frequency, that is used in a mobile phone, through intermediate frequency, that is generated by your computer screen or mobile screen, and to extremely low frequency, such as generated by power lines. Okay, the terms static refers the fields that do not vary with time. That is for static. The static magnetic fields are used in a medical imaging and generated by appliances using direct current. Now, this is the frequency range. This range of electromagnetic fields, as we see, this 0 hertz, nothing but the static field. Then below 300 hertz, called as an extremely low frequency, that is used in power line or your home appliances. All the home appliances are operated at this range of frequency. Then from 300 hertz to 100 kilohertz, this is the range for IF frequency, called as an intermediate frequency, and applications are in welding devices. Similarly, from 100 kilohertz to 300 gigahertz, the frequency range in radio frequency, what is RF frequency, and all kinds of microwave ovens, your mobile phone, cell phone, television, FM radios, all are operated in this frequency range. Then above 300 gigahertz to tetrahertz frequency, that is in the category of infrared, visible light, ultraviolet, X-ray and gamma rays. This is the one kind of frequency spectrum, and this is also one kind of frequency spectrum here. That is the into this side, the frequencies are increasing from to higher side. That means wavelength is increasing. Sorry, wavelength is decreasing, means from long wave to short wave. Okay, this is the kind of electromagnetic spectrums and frequency range for electromagnetic fields. Now we discuss the application of the electromagnetic fields in various allied disciplines. That is first application in microwave. We discuss this microwave in a special subject in final year, microwave engineering. Then antennas, the electrical machine, then satellite communication, bioelectromagnetics, then plasma, nuclear research, fiber optics. This is also the one special subject in final year. Electromagnetic interference and compatibility, electromechanical energy conversion, radar meteorology, remote sensing, these are and many more application of this electromagnetic field. And if you see the application, so this is very important subject for electronics and telecommunication as well as electrical students also. I can see some specific application for this subject is in induction heater. In induction heater, electromagnetic fields are used in induction heater for melting, forging, annealing, surface hardening and soldering operation also. And again in dielectric heating equipments, this is used like a short wave, that means high frequency wave, to join or seal a thin sheet of plastic material. Similarly, in agriculture field, this kind of energy offers many new and exciting possibilities in agriculture. For example, it is used to change vegetable taste by producing acidity. Now again we see the devices, those are operated on the principle of electromagnetics. That is, first device is a transformer, that is electrical device, then electrical relays, electrical motors, this is for electrical engineering, then radio and television, telephone, your mobile handset, transmission line, waveguide, antenna, optical fiber, then radars, lasers and many more devices. Those are operated on electromagnetics. So as we see that devices, then design of such kind of all the devices require thorough knowledge of the laws and principle of electromagnetics. Okay, so whenever you go to design, then you must know the knowledge of the principle and laws of electromagnetics. Now we focus the sources of electromagnetic waves. Now there are two kinds of sources. One is the natural source, as we discussed in previous slides, and one kind of source is the man-made. So natural source is Earth is our natural source of magnetism, because Earth has two poles, north and south. Therefore, it produces the magnetisms. And electric field is produced due to the buildup of electric charges in the atmosphere associated with thunderstorm. So this is the two example of generating the electromagnetic fields naturally. And man-made source is categorized in a different frequency range. And first category is low frequency range, that is frequency from 0 or maximum up to 300 Hz, that is called as a low frequency electromagnetic fields. And this low frequency electromagnetic fields is everywhere available in your home appliances. Plugging a wire of electrical appliances into the socket creates electric field in the ear which is surrounding that appliances, and this field remains as it is even if that appliances is not switched on. Therefore, electricity power plant operated at 50 Hz frequency in India or 60 Hz frequency in USA, that and all electrical home appliances are the major source of low frequency electromagnetic fields. Then we see the sources of high frequency, that is the intermediate frequency fields, ranging from 300 Hz to 100 kHz. Your computer screen, your mobile screen also, all kind of video display screen, electronic security systems like anti-theft devices operated at the exit of shops, then induction hot plates, these are the some devices, the source of IF field. Then we see the radio frequency, RF radio frequency. What is RF EM field? That is frequency range from 100 kHz to 300 GHz. Radio, television, mobile phone, antennas, microwave oven, these are the some devices that are the sources of electromagnetic fields in RF category. Now, can we see the effects of electromagnetic? What is the effect of electromagnetic fields? First of all, we see the effects due to extremely low frequency, that is from 0 to 300 Hz, very low frequency. What is the effects on human body due to such kind of low frequency? As we know, the use of electricity has become an integral part of everyday life. Whenever electricity flows, both electric and magnetic fields exist close to the lines that carries electricity and close to appliances. That means this electric field and magnetic field intensity is very large or higher near to the wire or near to the line, and as we go away from this wire or line, then that intensity is decreases. At lower frequency, externally developed electric field and magnetic fields induces the circulating current in the human body. This induced current is very, very small at low frequency. Therefore, this is not harmful for human body. As we see in diagram, such kind of induced current is developed in human body. And as we see that this cable produce the electromagnetic fields, but this cable is very long distance from ground, and therefore the intensity is very low near the ground. But if it goes away, goes near to the line, that power line, then that intensity is very high. Now again, this extremely low frequency field have electric and magnetic components. Extremely low frequency electric fields are particularly stronger close to the high power line, high voltage power line, and Extremely low frequency magnetic fields are particularly stronger near to induction furnace and welding machines. Okay, now we discuss the next frequency that is called as the IF frequency and the repeats. Now intermediate frequency, as we know, ranging from 300 Hz to 100 kHz. Well-known biological repeats at the intermediate frequency range are nerve stimulation at lower end, that means at 300 Hz, and heating at the upper end of the range, that is at 100 kHz. The few studies conducted have focused on potential effect on the eyes, on the cardiovascular system, on cancer, and on reproduction. But very few studies have addressed the biological effects of intermediate frequency field, while there is a limited evidence regarding potential effects on reproduction and development. Studies on their effects are virtually non-existent. So therefore, this type of frequencies are also not harmful for human body. Some medical applications lead to exposure in this frequency range, like electrosurgery that use an electric current to cut or remove the tissues, and magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, that provides three-dimensional images of internal structure such as brain. Okay, now we focus the next frequency range, that is RF frequency and the repeats. As we know, this is the radio frequency range from 100 kHz to 300 kHz. And an electromagnetic field at radio frequency causes a heating of body tissue. If the RF field strength is large, then stimulation of nerves and muscles takes place. So heating is the main biological effect of electromagnetic field at radio frequency. In microwave oven, use the RF frequency, and we know in microwave oven that this fat is employed to warm up a food. So just imagine, food is warm, so it is very dangerous for human body also. Therefore, the level is very important. And that level of radio frequency field to which the people are normally exposed are very much lower than those needed to produce the significant heating. And that is called as the threshold. Therefore, if the level of radio frequency field is very less below the threshold value, then it is okay. But if this value is more, then heating takes place. Therefore, we must know the specific absorption rate of our mobile devices by our human body. Scientists are also investigating the possibilities that effects below the threshold level for body heating occurs as the result of long-term exposure. Therefore, we must know what is the specific absorption rate of your mobile device so that that radio frequency fields level is below the threshold value. Then we discuss what is SAR value in this slide. SAR is nothing but the specific absorption rate, and it is a measure of rate at which energy is absorbed per unit mass by a human body when exposed to a radio frequency electromagnetic field. Now it can also be referred to absorption of other form of energy by tissue, including ultrasound also. Therefore, it is defined as the power absorbed per mass of a tissue, and as unit is watt per kilogram, because mass in kg and power in watt, the unit is watt per kg. Therefore, how much amount of power our body absorb per kg of mass. The SAR is generally or usually averaged either over whole body or a small sample of volume, typically either 1 gram or 10 gram of tissue also. Okay. So what is the specific absorption rate of for a cellular phone? The FCC, it is Federal Communications Commission, limits for public exposure from cellular telephone is an SAR level of 1.6 watt per kilogram. Therefore, this 1.6 watt per kilogram is the threshold value below which RF fields is compatible or useful for human body. But if the level of this RF field is greater than 1.6 watt per kg, then it is very dangerous for human body, because heating takes place, and as heating takes place, then it is very dangerous for human body. There are so many lot of health issues arises. We discuss these health issues in next slide also. And in from 1st September 2013, the mobile handsets with revised SAR value of 1.6 watt per kg would be permitted to be manufactured or imported in India also. Because before 13, India SAR value is in India SAR value was 2 watt per kg, but now from 13 some rules are stringent and strict, and now in India also 1.6 watt per kg RF value is threshold value is defined. Now, how to check the radiation level of your mobile phone? I will also give the one activity to you to check your radiation level of your mobile phone, and if it is below 1.6, then this is okay for operating your mobile phone. And already you know, mobile phone becomes very indispensable part of our lives. Now situation is like we can't even imagine our life without mobile phone in hand. So excessive use of smartphone causes a severe health disorder and can reduce your life in a long run. According to World Health Organization WHO, excessive use of cell phones causes a brain cancer due to radiation effect. You won't get ad hoc effect on your health in a short run, but after some 5 to 10 years, it causes a health issues like cancer also. In general, radiation level of a mobile phone calculated by SAR value. SAR is already been discussed in previous slide. That SAR represents the specific absorption rate. Every mobile manufacturer companies sets a limit on the SAR value that they emit from their products. SAR value represents amount of radio frequency energy absorbed by the body while using mobile phone. It is measured in watt per kilogram. Higher SAR value denotes the higher radiation level. Therefore, SAR value must be less than 1.6 watt per kg, that means below threshold level. Now, how to check the SAR value in your mobile phone? It is very simple to check the SAR value. Just you dial the number, that is *#07#, and this code is actually called as a USDD code in your mobile phone. What is USDD? Because you are ENDS engineer, you must know the long form of USDD and this concept. Basically, USDD is nothing but the unstructured supplementary service data. It's also called as quick code or also called as feature code. It is a communication protocol used by GSM cellular telephone to communicate with the mobile network operator computer. When the user or customer send this code to the telephone company, that may be any company like Vodafone or BSNL or any companies that you use the that mobile device, any company, then that it receives by a computer dedicated to USDD. The computer responds sent to back to the mobile device, generally in a one basic format that easily read by user. And by sending this code, then that device, that company, that operator will send you the SAR value of your mobile phone, and that SAR value may be total whole body or only for head, because generally mobile phone is kept at head. Therefore SAR value for head is given, as well as whole body is also given, but both SAR values must be less than 1.6 watt per kg. Okay, so this 1.6 watt per kg is the threshold value for the radiation level. If SAR value is less than 1.6, It's okay to use that phone if the SAR value is exceed this threshold limit. Consider take necessary steps to avoid radiation impact. That means you change your handset also. You can change handset. Recommended you to change your mobile phone itself by if SAR value is high. Because if it is high, you are going to face a lot of health issues like headache, mental stress, even cancer in the long run. Okay, so I will give you one activity. You check your SAR value first by dialing this code. As this code is you dial, you get SAR value. There are different codes, like suppose star hash 06 hash nothing but you get the mobile equipment identification number of your mobile phone. There are different codes, just like you send this code to check your balance, check your signal strength, check your battery information. There are different codes you can send to the operators, and operator send you that kind of information. So the first activity is to check your SAR value, and after that you send me that SAR level, SAR value of your mobile device to me, either by on WhatsApp group or personally on my WhatsApp group, either text message or in a screenshot format. But definitely you all must send this SAR value so that I can understand that you all have listened this video at the end of this lecture. Okay, this is a summary of this lecture. As we discussed the frequency range from static, extremely low frequency, IF and radio frequency. This is the frequency range of different frequencies, and these are some examples of exposure of sources from which device that kind of frequencies are produced, that is the sources of that frequencies. As we know, in extremely low frequency, your home appliances, power lines, all kinds of welding devices are the sources of extremely low frequency. Similarly, IF frequency, your mobile camera, laptop, all kinds of video display screen, the source of IF frequency. And radio frequency, as I already told you that mobile telephones, broadcasting, television, microwave ovens, radars, radio transceivers, portable radios, MRI, so that all kinds of devices produce the RF frequencies. So this is my first lecture, and this is theoretical lectures, and next lectures we start the vector algebra, that is a mathematical totally. And this subject is already told that this is mathematical subjects. You must cover the mathematical concept first. So in next lecture we discuss the vector algebra. Okay, thank you very much.